Hey VC, VK here with a vinyl update of some stuff I picked up over the last couple weeks. Haven't done one in a while and actually haven't been out in a while, so I want to at least show some stuff that I've added to the collection. Listening, or at least what I got going on right now, is Metal Massacre 4. That's on Metal Blade Records and features... I got the first side going right now. I got Sacred Blade, Death Dealer, Trouble, Scepter, Zetrope, and Warcry. And a sort of collection of Metal Blade artists. I might have showed this before, but this came out in 83. And you got to love what they say in the back here. I don't know if we can get the glare there, but put the volume to maximum. You got to love it. I mean, come on. It's classic stuff right there. Get that there. So, I want to show some records, and first of all, I want to thank all the new subscribers. I hope you kind of get a kick out of some of the stuff I show here, and, you know, I try to add a little humor to things, so kind of spice it up a little, you know, have some fun. Again, broadcasting here from the VK Lounge in the beautiful Chicagoland area. Let's just get to it, I guess, huh? The first record I'm going to show is the Kinks. Give the People What They Want. And, you know, I picked this up for $1, I think. And it was, I got it at the, it was a DuPage County All Night Flea Market. Pretty clean vinyl era stuff. Didn't have it, you know, trying to build a Kinks collection. I might have 3 or 4 records of them. So I was happy to find that. I haven't played that yet. But hope to get to it. I just want to give it a nice little wipe down. The next one I got was Billy Thorpe, Children of the Sun. It was one of those, you know, records I just never picked up back in the day. I mean, it was a popular song. It was kind of, I guess you want to say, one hit wonder. I don't know. I don't know much except for the main song, but, you know, for $1, again, at the all-night flea market, can't go wrong, on Polydor Red Label. I don't know. I thought it was just a good pickup. I didn't have it. It's probably the only Billy Thorpe album I probably will get unless I really get into it. But, you know, you never know. The next one, kind of a string of radio-friendly one-hit wonders here. This is Dave Mason. Let It Flow, and the song, the main song on here was We Just Agree, but Let It Flow was a good tune too. But Dave Mason also, I believe, was a member of Traffic. So, you know, this one is kind of too, The Wife Loves That Song, We Just Disagree, oddly enough. this is a nice label to it. It's on Columbia, a little custom label there. You can check that out. Kind of cool looking there. And also had a, you know, you don't see this, I haven't seen this too much, a die cut inner sleeve. So it's, you know, basic sleeve, but this one has the lyrics on, so it shows off the label. You know, usually that is just a plain wrapper, you know, and with the hole in the middle. But that's kind of cool that he put the lyrics around that, kind of shows off the label. And I thought it was neat, you know, easily, simple minds are easily amused. What are you going to do? Next one is Jerry Rafferty, City to City. And, of course, this has the main radio-friendly hit, Baker Street. So I thought that, you know, picked it up for that. Didn't have this. Didn't have it on CD or anything like that. So thought it was cool to have, you know. What's cool about this, I believe... this is a German pressing on United Artists. So that's kind of cool. In fact, I think there's a couple other ones that I found that were German pressings. These I got from a thrift store. These were from the Goodwill. I'm sorry. These were from Goodwill, some of the German pressings. Somebody must have just dropped off their German pressings, because I got a couple other ones. I know there's a Uriah Heep in here that was a German pressing, and I think I showed one of my ELO albums before. If not, I'll have to show it again. That was also a West German pressing, or a German pressing. Another one, you know, I picked it up just because I didn't have it. You know, I do like a couple of the tunes on this record. I mean, I like the band, don't get me wrong. Yeah, they're, you know, some call them corporate rock, you know, 70s, 80s cheese, whatever you want to call it. But REO Speedwagon's Nine Lives. You know, this is kind of the bridge between REO being kind of the rock band and then kind of getting into the pop 80s ballads and stuff. The album between You Can't Tune a Fish and then High Infidelity. But, you know, some of it gets a little too poppy for me, but songs like Only the Strong Survive, Back on the Road Again, you know, still a great cut. But, you know, even the cover, you know, the guys started wearing the spandex. It's, you know, look at Cronin in that outfit. I'm like, yeah, it's like the 79 disco era going on. Are we going to go kind of follow that trend with the fashion, rock, and all? I don't know. Kind of a weird thing for him. But, you know, it's a gatefold curse here with the guys. Like I said, look at... I don't know about them. It was hard to kind of take that after, you know, loving their live album. Big fan of the live album, You Get What You Play For. Plus albums like REO2 and their debut, and then even Tuna Fish was great, but kind of. I know I remember in like eighth grade or so, you know, a couple of guys were really into this record, and that's when I was getting, you know, discovering Led Zeppelin, so it was kind of cheesy like Speedwagon then. And then when High Infidelity came out, it was like, oh, that was the chick flick, you know, that was the chick flick version of music at the time. So another record I picked up for a buck, another early 80s amp, but you know, these guys are Southern rockers, and that's 38 Special Forces. Decent album, you know, I'm sure many of you probably have that. We'll go into detail of that one. This one I picked up at a Goodwill too, and I thought really the cover was in great shape. It's James Taylor flag at the front. And then inner cover of JT there. You know, I'm a JT fan. I got a lot of his records as well. Nice hard inner sleeve there. The multi-flag color labels there. A nice album, you know. Nothing really... Rainy Day Man is good. But, you know, the cover is in beautiful shape. I mean, there's not even any ring wear. It's really, the gloss is still there. So, you know, I had to pick that up and add it for the JT collection. This next one, you know, I love this band since the first time I heard it. I think one of the first songs I ever got into this band, and you'll know it now, would be Godzilla. I picked up Blue Oyster Cult's Agents of Fortune. I picked this up for a buck too at a Goodwill, and I couldn't believe to find BOC in a Goodwill in this condition. I don't know if maybe one of the guys can answer this question. It didn't have a custom inner sleeve, so but I didn't see a barcode. So if anybody has this and there is an inner sleeve, it comes on the Red Columbia label. But you know, if there was a inner sleeve to that, you know, drop a comment. Let me know if you have that or seen it. The thing about inner sleeves, and I'll kind of go off on a tangent here. You know, I don't think it gets enough credit. You know, when I used to get a record and I get this white label, I'd be bummed out. I mean, I want to see song lyrics, I want to see pictures, or heck, even just advertisements of other records from the label. But you know, you get a white sleeve, you're like, come on, man, you could put a little more creativity in that, right? And I noticed on a lot of the videos I watch, a lot of people don't show the inner sleeve. You know, we kind of just hold up the record and we kind of bypass the inner sleeve. And I kind of, you know, come to the videos a lot of times to see, you know, what I should be looking for out there in the wild. You know, I pick up a record, you know, if it has an inner sleeve, you know, great, and posters and all the other little extras that used to come with records was always something, you know, that I would look for. And you know, I start to notice it on the VC, some of the guys that do pull it out. So thanks for doing that, but hey man, you know, give the inner sleeve some love. Next one is you know, a favorite for many VC members, considered it a classic. I've never had this album. I don't know why. I never picked it up. I picked up a copy. It's pretty bad, actually, but I'm doing it as a starter, and that's King Crimson in the Court of the Crimson King. Like I said, this sucker's has been used and well played. I mean, I got a tear here in the inner bottom here. What are you gonna do? I mean, it was a buck, so I had to pick it up at least. Vinyl's not in bad shape. You know, it probably needs a good cleaning. Not that you can see it here, but you know, like I said, I didn't have it. It's kind of a starter until I could find an upgrade copy of it. Hoping to do that relatively soon without paying an arm and a leg on it. But, you know, for a buck, I thought it was at least a good starter. You know, why not? So, next. Got an album here, you know, Boss Skaggs. Middleman. Still have the shrink on it. I'll probably take it off. It's no big deal. There's no, like, stickers on it. And in fact, I'll take it off right now. How about that? It was already ripped. There's no cool little price tag stickers or hype stickers or anything like that. So here you go. We're taking the shrink off of that. No big deal. I mean, sometimes shrink is cool. If it has, you know, stickers, I'd like to leave it on. If not, when they start to come off, you take them off. You know, eventually I'll get sleeves for it. This did have an inner sleeve. It's kind of the smoke rising up there like that. Kind of cool, huh? And some stuff on the back. Song titles, band members, and this is, of course, on the Red Columbia label. I have, I think, Boss Skaggs Hits. You know, obviously, I like all the tunes on there, so when I saw this for a buck, I figured, you know, get more Boss Skaggs. Can't all be bad, right? Next one is another album that, you know, I have a lot on CD of this artist. I got a couple albums. I just recently picked up Plays Live, and I've had So, and of course I'm talking about Peter Gabriel, and this is Security. Picked this up for $1. This was at the Fleet All Night Flea Market. This is a promo gold stamp. Got a hype sticker on there. There's all kinds of things on there. And then, you know, maybe here's another question for you guys. It has this on here. I didn't see anything on the label, you know, if it was a, what that actually was, if it was just a special vinyl printing or the way it was, you know, mastered or what. Again, you know, he has a custom inner sleeve with the lyrics, photos, and this is on Geffen. But again, I couldn't see anything different about on the label about it, and I have another record. I think it was my Motley Crue's Dr. Feelgood that has that same stamp. This quick, I can't even pronounce it. Two limited edition pressing. So if anybody has you know, an answer for what that might mean, is it just the grade of vinyl? Is it the way it was mastered onto the album? I don't know. But again, Peter Gabriel Security, really happy to at least get a copy of this. I'll probably still have to look for an upgrade. It covers a little worn and stuff, but, you know, for $1, I'll take it all day. Another one I have here, love this guy, Michael Schenker Group, favorite when I was younger. This is also a gold stamp promo. And, you know, it comes with the inner sleeve. Michael, look at the flying V. Fantastic stuff. It's on a chrysalis. And, yeah, it could be cleaned up a little, you know, some fingerprints and things like that. But the vinyl's in pretty decent shape, I think. There's no big scratch marks or anything like that. So I was happy about that. That was for $1 also from the All Night Flea Market. And the last one I got, here's another one I told you about, the West German printings. This is, I got this at the Goodwill too, and this was Uriah Heep's Fallen Angel. You know, this has a, falls out like that. And you gotta love this cover, anybody. How can you not like that? That's pretty cool, right? Yeah, that's cool. I got the inner gatefold lyrics. Picture of the band, and this one had an insert as well, so it was really you know, you find stuff like that that did the test of time, was cool. On the insert, I noticed, this is where I kind of realized this was from Germany, obviously, because I guess I'm most of it in German. On this side, it was just a picture of the discography of some of their albums. And on the other side was cool, was the Uriah Heep on tour, 1979. And this is a European tour, and mostly, I want to say these are mostly all German dates. I could be wrong, but I thought this was, you know, and the fact, look at this thing. I mean, the corners are nice, kind of, you know, they're not beat up. There's no marks. I thought this was, you know, it's like brand new to me. Of course, the bummer was that the inner sleeve was plain. But it is on the bronze album label. And let's see if we can get a good shot of that. And it's a, you know, West German print. So I was excited about that. Vinyl's really clean. I don't know, whoever got this maybe wasn't a... didn't listen to it much or sat on the shelf or I don't know, but I'm excited to get this going and spin this, and I thought it was cool with the insert, you know. So those are most of the finds I got recently. Hope you know, saw something in here that you might have, you'd comment on it, we'd discuss it. If anybody had any answers about the inner sleeves on some of those records that have plain ones, if you know that they have, you know, custom print ones, great. And that's it. So, again, thanks everybody for subscribing, and I'll talk to you again.